So welcome to Hatha Yoga. And in our Hatha class today, we're going to need to be close to a wall that you can actually put your legs up on. So we're going to do what's called legs up the wall. That's fairly intuitive. As a release posture at the end of the class. So it's a restorative posture. And you can use a blanket if you want. Sometimes it's nice to have some cushion under your hips. Sometimes it's nice to drape the blanket over your feet. So just kind of a heads up as to where we'll head towards the end of class. And then as we get going here, just going to start in seated, start with our breath. And our focus today is going to be on shoulders. It's also going to be on your feet. So kind of an odd combination, but the thing is that sometimes our tension is here, and sometimes as we release from the bottom, from our feet up, we can kind of meet in the middle, and our hips and everything else will get their movement, but that's kind of where we're taking our attention. So as you settle into a comfortable seated position, have it something that you feel confident with. If you have a block close by, a book, I always mention, pop that up under your knees to give your hips a bit of space. Sit on something like the edge of a blanket, but get comfortable. Sit on your knees if you want. Take a moment to pause here. Maybe just rock your shoulders up to your ears and then push them away. And rock them up. And push them away. What I'm going to have you do is arc your shoulders back. So puff your chest up, rock your ribs forward like a tiny little cow back, and then roll your shoulders forward. Feel your collarbones kind of shrink in. Broaden your collarbones out. And rock your shoulder blades forward. Rock your shoulders right up to your ears, down to the back. And all the way back down away from the ears, and let them stay there. Wiggle it out a little bit. Take just a brief moment to turn your head left, pausing to focus on the neck. Roll through the center, turn your head right. Notice, is there anything that's grounded today? One more time, left. Walk over to the right. Last thing we'll do is come back through the center. Drop your chin down towards your chest. Pause there for just about three breaths. Shoulders heavy, arms heavy. The very top of your head is heavy. Let that trickle down the back of the head and the neck. Let the neck become soft. On an inhale, bring the head back to center. Let the eyes stay closed. Rock the ribs back a little bit and settle into the sit bones. Just want you to keep your eyes low or closed and begin to pull back behind the eyes. Pull back inside of your own thoughts. Pause and imagine that you are in a capsule. You're on your mat, just kind of cocooned in your own space here. With your eyes closed, you're sitting inside your headspace. Pausing just to take a glance around at your thought that dances around. So notice how it moves. As if you're watching a movie, notice the things that are floating in front of you, like the credits of a movie. And you see the same things rolling again and again and again. Pluck a few of those things out of that scrolling credit. Toss them over to one side. Just grabbing whatever feels appropriate to grab. Now imagine those credits just slowly drifting off the screen, out of your vision. You have a blank slate, a dark screen. Begin pulling those thoughts back over again, just setting them around in that space. As if you're placing them on a board. Shift them around, arrange them as you like, and notice what thoughts tend to be most prominent. Are there some that are bigger? You take all the smaller thoughts, push them off to another side. And now notice what remains. As you glance at those thoughts, as you repeat the message in your mind, is there a theme? Is there something that you could acknowledge that might need to stay with you during your practice? Maybe those thoughts all stay right there on that screen. Maybe you slide another one or two off to the side and just begin to focus on that one thought. Let's let that thought become our intention. Imagine that thought illuminating on that dark board so that the background becomes lighter and lighter and lighter. And that thought becomes more vibrant. Like an ignition, your breath now is the illuminator of that thought. So you take a deep breath in. Feel like your breath is brightening your thought. As you take a breath out, you're continuing to dust all the rest of the thoughts off to the side. Inhaling, brightening your thought. Exhaling, depress away the edges. Inhale deeply. Exhale fully. Breathe into the ribs. Breathe out all the way out to your mouth. Seek that brightness, that illumination of your thoughts, your intention. Make your breath deeper, broader, fuller, longer. Exhale to let go. All the rest. Allow yourself the patience it takes to keep your thought with you during your practice. And take a moment to bring your hands to heart center. As we pause at heart center, Anjali Mudra. Our mudra is symbolic. It's us committing. We let the heart in to honor the body, to honor who you are, to honor who you are today and where your body is today. So listen to your body. Give it what it needs to support, to encourage, and to let go. Give honor to your intention and use your breath to make that connection, to illuminate it. If things start creeping into that white space again, push them off to the side. Your exhale. Just patiently let them go. And Let your breath release the hands right back down. On your inhale, slowly roll the eyes open. Bring your shoulders up and around, down. Just do that a few more times again to wake up the shoulders. Drawing big circles. And then do the same in the opposite direction. Rolling back and up and forward. On your next roll, let the arms just float back down. And just kind of wiggle it out a little bit. Roll the ribs, turn it, almost kind of sway it side to side. Let your hands rub your thighs or just move about. Just going to kind of circle around, grab my knees, and just begin to roll the ribs a bit. Rock forward on your sit bones, roll back around to the edges. If it feels crazy in your seated position and you want to move your legs, do it, right? Move them out, let them be broad. You can do the same thing here. Do what you want with your legs. Feel comfortable. And roll it back the other direction. There's no rules to how we do it or pattern. Just letting things move a little bit. Stirring up the middle. Stirring up the spine. And finally, taking a little bit of a rock back on your sit bones. Knee back and scoop the legs to free them. I'm going to turn lengthwise on my mat. Stay facing where you feel most comfortable towards me. We'll work from short to long end, end to short end of the mat today. And as we sit back here, I'm just going to have you settle your hands. We're not so focused on the shoulders for the moment. I just want you to lift your toes up, finesse your feet so that they feel comfortable. Your knees feel comfortable, hips comfortable. You can settle in your arms, kind of relax here. And just fan your feet left and right. Swivel on your heel. Rock your toes. Try to keep your knees just comfortably steady. They don't need to move too much right now, but just rock your heels left and right, your toes in and out, and fanning them. Reach the toes to the mat. Walk your feet a little further so the toes might creep off, and can you point your toes firmly down? Squeeze the toes under, curl them. Flare your toes. Reach your pinky toe towards the floor and your big toe toward the ceiling. Curl your toes and flare your toes. I know, nothing very exciting, but it feels really good when we're done. Flare the toes. And keep flaring your toes and curl the toes back so you're flexing again through the calf or through the toes, tops of the foot, and elongating the back of the leg. And then point it back down again. Just do that a few times. Flare the toes, pull the toes, and then foot back, flex, and curl it back under. Do it one more time, pull it back, and point. And as you flare back, you can just pause there, creep your heels in, draw your feet into a butterfly position. So the bottoms of the feet are hugged together, and we rock a bit side to side. I'm going to grab a hold of my feet, my toes. I'm just going to give my feet a little squeeze. I'm going to take my thumbs and put my thumbs in the arch of my foot and start squeezing the feet. Just like you're massaging, pinching the top of your foot all the way down your arch, squeezing into the arch of the foot, squeezing back to the toes. And move around a little bit, right? Move it to the inside arch of your foot. Walk down the belly of the foot, right down the middle. Move your way back up again, back and forth. You can even just kind of slide your hands, your own little massage here on your feet, moving it back and forth. And then get your entire foot, both feet, if you want, just a big squeeze. Squeeze from the inside out. Push your toes together, hug your feet a little bit. And then finally, I'm just going to rock my sit bones. So rock side to side, rock the sit bones closer to your heels. Hug on wherever you want to on the feet, whether it's here at your ankles, on the foot itself, in the arch, on the toes, or on the crown. And lift your heart up. As you lift the heart up, rock your sit bones again. Give your shoulder blades a nice squeeze in. Lift your heart. And pull forward here. The feet are pressing together. We're using our feet as our connection point. Even wing your elbows out so that maybe you can give your elbows a nudge into your knees. So now focus on your shoulders. Not here, but push the shoulders down. The shoulders get pushed into the arms into the legs come to the floor. And keep pulling my shoulder blades back and down to try to reach the heart past your toes. Keep pressing the knee elbows down or the shoulders down to the elbows and to the knees. Now take another deep breath, and on your exhale, can you let the head fall? Let the shoulders roll forward, relax the shoulders. So you release some of that tension in the elbows or press in the knees. And you keep your elbows resting on your knees and your shoulders relax, your head dropping so that we're scooping around in the back. Or maybe if you're one of those that can lie closer to the floor, maybe your chest comes down to your toes and you can just simply lay down on the floor. Take that as an option. For me, a little bit more tense there and shortened, so I'm just going to continue to relax down. My elbows might dribble into the floor or kind of dribble toward the floor. So let your shoulder blades fall away from your spine. Relax the back of the neck. Top of the head goes heavy. Take a deep breath in and illuminate that intention. And a deep breath out, letting go of everything else. Deep breath in. Exhaling to let go of the tension you might feel in the back, the neck, the shoulders, the hips. Breathing in and breathing out. As you take your next breath, lift up through the head, press the hands so we can lift the heart, walk the hands back in. As you walk the hands back in, just take a gentle scoop around the knees and hug the knees in. With the knees hugged in, walk your feet out here a moment, and now lean back, and I want you to focus on the opposite, so on your shoulders here. So turn the hands away for a moment towards the back of the mat, walk your hands back so you're leaning, spread the fingers out, and lift up through the chest, squeeze the shoulder blades, open across the front of the shoulders, puff the ribs up. If you don't feel much here, then one of two things, either pause, relax the shoulders, and creep your hips forward, or walk your hands back either way. The other option is to walk your hands maybe a bit closer to one another. Then push the sit bones down, the hips forward, the ribs up, and lift the chin. We're all different in how much space we have in the shoulders, so listen to your body again. Lift the ribs, push down through your connections of the mat, through the sit bones, through the hands. One more deep breath in. And as you exhale, soften the spine. Start walking the hands back in so that we can feel the thumb. And take yourself around to where you're on your knees and your hands. And from the knees and the hands, spread the fingers out so you have a good connection, or tuck your fists under if you're watching your wrists. And bring your toes tucked under. And we're going to kind of do the same thing we did when we were seated with the heels on the floor. Here the toes are on the floor. So can you rock your heels out and rock your heels in? And if you need to, you can widen your knees so that your ankles don't crash in the middle of your heels. Rock the heels out and in. The only thing I want you to focus on in your shoulders is that we're not crowding the ears. So pull the shoulders back. Keep your tailbone a little tucked so we're not dribbling the hips and the belly down. And pause back in the middle. Tuck the toes right under the knees. Flare the toes out, and can you begin to push into your toes? Try to stretch the toes open. I'm going to walk my hands back just a little bit, so I put a little bit more press into the feet. And can you wiggle your feet just enough to feel like you can get every single toe to touch the mat? Your pinky toe to your big toe. Walk back a little bit if you need to. Pinky toe to big toe. Push every toe down. Flare them out. Now, the more we walk back, the more intensity we feel here. So if it's really intense for you, come right back to here. If you can lift your heart a bit more, maybe walk your hands up your legs, slowly shifting the weight of the body backwards. So if I feel like this is my stopping point, I'm just going to stop here. relax the shoulders, take a breath, or maybe lift up a bit more. Maybe lift up a little bit more. The toes are spread out, pulling the feet open from the bottom. And stay here, you can pause back at your Ajna Mudra. Find your breath, inhale deeply, illuminate. Exhale deeply, let go. All the interference, all the resistance. Inhale. Exhale. Let's get one more breath. When you take your next exhale, lean it forward, walk down the legs. The hands to the mat, slowly flip the feet open. And this is where you're going to make a little noise, so kind of pat your feet out. You're just going to let go of all that tension, pat out the tops of the feet and the toes, and release there. And once you've released, wiggle with your toes to just relaxed on the mat, kind of wiggle your feet a little bit so we get a little bit of space there. And with that space, we're going to rock our way back a little bit deeper onto the feet. Not quite as intense, but come on back. So let's take it here. Rocking back, same idea, but I want you to push back until you're floating on tops of the balls of the feet. So on the balls of the feet here, walk your hands to where you feel balanced and rock forward and back just a little bit. Rock to where your heels want to reach back down toward the floor, knees then rock toward the front. So again, we'll stretch the toes. We won't spend as much time rocking forward as we will pausing toward the back, kind of letting this ride up the legs a little bit. So rock back. Just going to walk my hands with my chest a little bit. I'm going to feel settled in the heels. My ball of my foot settled with the heels floating. The ball of the foot is your firm press point. And what we'll do is just wiggle a little bit. So turn your knees left and right. Just let them sway side to side. And in turn, of course, your hips are going to sway. Your feet are going to shift weight from the inside to the outside. And then take a moment if you can and just kind of begin to walk your feet towards me. Walk your feet, walk your feet, or to the right. Let's try that. Walk your feet towards the right. If you need to and come up here, that's fine for a moment. But what I'd like you to do is use your connection on your legs to push the knee away. Keep your hands here, whether it's on the block or the floor, or maybe it's just your elbow on your knee, and push the knees toward the edge of your mat. Turn your toes, and then turn the rest of the body towards the short end of your mat. So beginning to twist the spine, pull the shoulder that's away from the knees away further, so that you're pulling around, squaring the shoulders toward the edge of the mat. Again, if that feels crowded, hands here on something that lifts the hands up. Take the elbow and push the knees away a little bit. Again, try to lift your heart, pull your shoulder blades back, and the knee farthest from your shoulder, farthest from your knees, pull it even farther. And slowly walk it back. Bring it back into the middle. Feel that reset in your spine. Turn the other way. Walk my feet around again. If I need to reset here, get setting, and turn it straight to the edge. My knees are pointing to my left, so I'm going to take my right shoulder, pull it back, and try to aim my heart towards the end of the mat, the short end. Use the elbow on the knee to push it away. So again, it could be up here or connected. Something that lifts your hands. Square your shoulders. Draw the knees away. So use your arm to push the knees toward the edge of the mat. The shoulders and strength of the upper body will pull around. Take a nice deep breath in, lift the heart. Relax your toes, relax your heels, relax your feet. One more breath. And as you exhale, walk the feet back around. All right. As we walk the feet back around, just press the hands enough that you can lift, flex your heels, melt it right into a forward fold at the back end of your mat. So in that forward fold, rock back and forth a little bit. Wherever your arms are, maybe they're dangling, maybe they're folded, keep a little bend in your knees or a lot if you're watching low back, and just rock until you can balance on your heel with your toe, forward and back. And I promise you that even though we're focusing on the feet today, this is the most intense focus on our feet. We're slowly going to work into our bigger postures and keep our feet in our mind and our attention. Let your shoulders now fall. Let your feet settle. Let the arms dangle or cup the elbows, fold the arms. Begin to lift your tailbone a little bit and tug on the back of the legs. Take a nice full breath. Let the arms fall free on the exhale. Soften your knees, scoop out your belly, roll it up to the top, roll the shoulders back. Down and lift the head. On an inhale, reach the arms to the sky. Look up towards your hands. Exhale back down to your heart and follow your hands to your heart, dropping your chin towards your chest. Again, inhale, look up. Open the arms, expand the shoulders, and exhale, brings your hands to your heart, look down to your hands. Inhale, opens. And exhale, drops back down. Pause right there. So as we pause here, roll the shoulders back and down. Find the feet again, just rock forward and back a couple of times to find the edge of your foot crest, the heel now heavy, and your toes lift them up just for a moment, float them back down to the mat so they're soft. Take a nice full breath. Inhale the arms up to the sky again and pause at heart center, eyes fixed towards the short edge of your mat. Shift your weight over to the right side and begin to float your left foot up. Knee comes up level with the hip, maybe below the hip. The toes are lifted. Find a little balance here. Your hip is heavy on the left side, so keep it from rising up. Notice how your body finds its balance, how the feet, the toes, the arch, the edge of the foot react. And slowly let the foot come right back down. Let's do it on the other side. Float it out. Balance. Okay, wherever you want to hold the leg, whether it's high or low, lift your toes. And lift the toes on both feet so that you feel both toes lighten up towards the ceiling. The left foot is pushing down to the mat, the edge, finding your balance here. Take a nice deep breath in. And on your exhale, bend your knees, but let's step forward this time. Creep your way out into your mat and find your way into Warrior One. The back foot's going to be turned slightly, but our hips are going to try to find their way around. So draw the front thigh bone back as if you're, it's like a saw. It's coming back and forth, right? So pull the right thigh bone back and hug the left and around. Press down through the edge of the feet. So I want you to find the edge. Rock out to the pinky edge of the foot and float your arms up to the sky. Shoulders drop heavy and elbows are going to open today. So I'm just about here, like goalposts. Turn the palms forward towards the short edge of your mat. Begin to lift the chin a bit. Feel like your heart and your ribs are lifting. Squeeze the shoulder blades together. As we focus on Warrior One, be confident in your feet. Your feet are your base, your core, your stability, your rooted connection. Pressing down and out. Bend the front knee. And pause here to just notice your shoulders. You're squeezing back. I mean, I want you to pull your shoulder blades together. Be strong in the upper back. But then begin to lift your elbows just a little and drop your elbows. And while you continue to squeeze your shoulder blades together, notice what it feels like from one side to the other, from one position to the next. Take a deep breath in. I want you to pause in that one spot that isn't your most comfortable, but the spot that maybe you need the most to open the shoulders. Again, take a deep breath and sit down a little bit deeper in the front leg. Wiggle out your toes. Don't let the toes grip. And start to straighten the arms. Now with the arms straight, squeeze your elbows. Flare out your hands. And reach as if you're trying to make your fingernails touch one another. Squeeze your shoulder blades. Keep squeezing. Keep pushing through the edge of your feet. Turn the palms toward the floor. And slowly begin to draw forward just a little bit and start reaching the palms back towards each other like they're going to hug a big ball behind you. Now, as we squeeze the arms together, roll the shoulders back, push into the front knee, sit down, but push back through the back edge of the back foot. Squeeze the shoulder blades. Take a nice deep breath, and on your exhale, can you soften your elbows, link your hands? If you can't link your hands, you're gonna grab a towel, or if you have a strap, take that strap between your hands. And my thumbs are turned to the outside, my palms face the body, and that's where I grab the towel. So either way, connecting the hands, roll the shoulders back. As we lean forward a little bit more, just pause there. Is that an okay position for you? Push through your feet. I want you to feel like you're pulling your mat apart. Squeeze your shoulder blades. Keep reaching your ribs towards your hip. And on your next deep breath, plant the hands, lift the hips, and step back to downward facing dog. And in your down dog, go ahead and lock it a little bit. Again, we've done a lot with our feet, so really we're just focused on calves and ankles, Achilles, but let it roll up the hips. Take a full breath on your exhale. Settle the feet. Spread out your fingers. Push down through the pointer and the thumb and kind of hug your elbows into the center, like you're pulling your arm, shoulder blades into your armpits. Can you push the ribs back a bit and lift your tailbone? Let your head fall. Relax your neck. Turn the head left, right. Nod back and forth. While the shoulders are strong here, pulling back away from the ears, helping to support our down dog, our neck goes soft. Deep breath in, illuminate. Deep breath out, let go. One more time, nice deep breath in. And as you exhale, soften your knees. Go ahead and take the walk back towards the back of your mat again. Deepen in your knees, back into forward fold. I'm just going to switch myself over to the other side here. Same forward fold. Same dangling of the arms or folding of the elbows. Maybe a little sway left and right. Rock your shoulders and arms to one side. Let your hips drift to the other. Let your neck go soft and relax the head down. Bring it back to center again. As you relax the arms, scoop the belly, bend your knees, uncurl the spine one vertebra at a time. Deep inhale, reach up to the top. As you exhale, bring your hands back down to your heart. Fix the gaze towards the short end of your mat. And let's shift again, switching sides. Now our left leg floats up to the top. Soften the base knee and step forward to find again, just kind of walking your way into warrior one. So we switch sides. Opposite leg is forward, back leg again, kind of turn diagonal. You can turn it more towards the front, more towards a lunge if you're watching hips and back. If we can, let's focus on those hips. Try to saw the front leg. Forward and back until you hold it back a bit. Round down through the feet. Inhale the arms up. Exhale the shoulders down. Again, drop the elbows. Right here, goal post. Sit down again. Wiggle your toes out and find the edge of your feet. Be grounded in that root connection at the mat. And then focus on the shoulders. Can we lift the elbows a little? Drop the elbows a little and squeeze your shoulder blades. Not just floating the arms. I want you to be engaged here. Squeeze the shoulder blades back, then rise and fall again. Use the upper back strength to open up chest and shoulders, like your collarbones are growing longer. Now pause in that one spot that you need the most. Again, it may not be your favorite spot, but just pause there. Squeeze the shoulder blades. Inhale, exhale, sit down in the front knee, push down through the back leg. Open the arms right from there. Once you get there, can you squeeze even tighter? Reach your fingernails toward each other. Inhale deeply, exhale deeply. On your next breath, slowly turn your palms down. Lean forward just a little bit, push through your back foot. Press back through the shoulders and reach your hands back like you're grabbing something behind you. So instead of your shoulders being low, can you peel them open? Pull your heart through. Roll the shoulders back. Squeeze your shoulder blades together. Reach the hands back firmly like you're going to grab against something behind you. And soften the elbows. Lengthen the hands. And begin to extend. So the first thing I want you to focus on is your shoulders. Pull them back. Again, grab the towel or the strap if you need it and use that to connect your hands. Squeeze the shoulder blades. Begin to lean forward a bit more and press through the back foot. Maybe the arms lift a little, maybe they just stay right where they are, focused on peeling up in the front of the body. And if you can bring your ribs a bit closer to your thigh, drift down here, humble warrior. So maybe it's high on the side, maybe it's a little deeper. Again, ultimately bringing the shoulder to the inside, dropping the head, and lifting the arms wherever they might journey. You be you, right? Each side is different, each day is different, each body is different. So be here and be present. Use your breath. Use your intention. Let's get one more breath. And as you exhale, push firmly into your foot. Lift the head, lift the heart. Press your feet, floating up. Let the arms sweep free. Lift out of the back foot and open up to warrior two. I'm just going to walk it out to where I feel really confident here, that I can open up the hips, that I can settle. My knee stays behind my toes. The back foot turned to your long edge, or maybe just slightly forward. Push out through the feet, float the arms. Let the shoulders relax down so they become heavy here. Look down towards your front hand, towards the short end of your mat. Breathe in and breathe out. The front knee, the bent knee, push it towards the pinky edge. Now take the back arm, let it relax. The shoulder's going to become heavy. And tuck the arm behind. So again, my arm might just dangle here, just kind of reaching back, relaxing on the glutes. Or maybe a creep up. I want to feel a reaction here, a little bit of space and opening. So squeeze the shoulder back and push your arm into your body. It might creep up a little bit, so maybe it's riding up the spine, like you're headed towards cow face. Again, not full cow face today if that's you. Wherever that arm feels most open, most space, most supported, sit down. Begin to drop the back shoulder and float the top arm. So coming into a reverse warrior with the back arm a little bit deeper connected, look up. Reach back, take the top arm, reach toward the short end of the mat behind you. Now again, take a breath, and on your exhale, just maybe rest on the top of the head. Use this connection, not to tweak the neck, right? But to use as a lever point, to peel the top shoulder open, bring your hand behind your head. Push the head into the hand and the hand into the head. And can you sweep the top shoulder open? Keep peeling the top shoulder back. Sit down. Breathe into your legs. Lots of work here in the lower half, opening in the upper half. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Get one more breath. As you exhale, release the top arm, step the shoulders, release the back arm, and release the arms together. Roll the shoulders a couple of times. I know legs are still working. Deep breath in. Back foot swivels up, open, dive down, find low lunge. When you get there, again, lift your hands on blocks if that works for you. Rock forward and back. Through the toes, through the ankle, through the feet. Front heel should be the heaviest space of your foot. So find that heavy space and pause. Draw the shoulders back, head up, and melt your hips toward the mat. So become heavy hip space. Strong in that leg. Full in your breath. Inhale deeply. And exhale deeply. One more full breath. And you exhale. Pause here to drop the back knee. Step the front leg back to all fours. And before we head back, we're going to dolphin. So elbows will come to the mat. Palms can either be together or flat on the floor. I like my palms together. Elbows under your shoulders, so no wider. Tuck your toes just like we would a down dog. Lift the knees, the hips, and push the ribs back. So press through your forearms to
push the front edge of the mat. Drop your head down, maybe it touches the mat, maybe it drifts, we're all put together differently. So just be where you are, pressing from the forearm, the hand, the elbows, and maybe walking the knees down. Pause to lengthen both legs. Walk your feet to where you feel most comfortable that you can push the mat away a bit further with the arms. Maybe lift the tailbone a little bit higher. Another deep breath in. And another exhale. And melt the knees to the mat. Just pause here in child's pose for a moment. A few breaths. Settling down through the hips. Relax the arms, let the shoulders soften. Bring a deep inhale and a deep exhale. Let the head melt into the mat so the neck goes soft, again, letting the shoulders relax even heavier. To take your next few breaths. Shift us towards Shavasana, not quite there yet, but finding our way into that space. Another deep breath in. Another deep breath out. And begin to slowly work your way to all fours on your hands and your knees. Find your way into cat-cow. Arcing the spine on the inhale, opening up the chest. Rounding the spine on the exhale. Rolling into your cat back. Inhale fully. And exhale. Lift your chin and your tailbone. And scoop it out. When we began our practice, we began in seated, played with the spine a little bit. We'll do the same thing here. So on your next inhale, come into neutral spine. Walk your knees maybe just slightly wider. Really feel comfortable in your hands or tuck your knuckles. Begin to roll the spine. Tuck into a cat back. Rock your ribs to one side as they fall towards the floor. Lift the head and the tailbone. Rock your ribs to the other side. Round it back out. Drawing a big circle with the head and the tailbone. Rolling it through the middle, rocking it open. Again, no rules, no perfect way to move, just gliding here. When it feels comfortable to you, pause somewhere, just switch directions, circle it back the other way. Lift the chin, lift the tailbone, pull the shoulders back, and then rock it forward. Take one more big circle of breath. On your next inhale, pause back in neutral space. Come around to seated. As you come to seated, what I'd like you to do is make that shift with me. So, again, if you have a blanket and you have it close by and you want to use it, I'll show you how you can use that to drape on your legs. If you've got socks, a jacket, and you want to keep that on for Shavasana, feel free to grab anything that helps you feel comfortable. And what we'll do is shift over to the wall. So I'm going to shift my mat here and just tee it up at the wall. And I'll show you how to get into this posture. So follow me first on how to get into the posture, and then when you feel comfortable, you can take it there yourself. What I'll do first is come up really close to the wall, and I'm going to scoot all the way over to the long edge of the mat. So I'm going to scoot my sit bones to the very edge. I'm going to sit as close as I can to the wall so that my thighs and my hips are touching, and then lean away. When I lean away, again, using my arms for support, I'm going to keep scooting my hips into the wall, turn my knees so my sit bones are on the wall. I'm now right at the edge of the mat, lay down, and roll backwards so that when I get back, my sit bones are still touching, my legs are floating up above the hips, and with the wall there for support, just let the legs dangle down and the arms are going to relax, and we'll get you set here in a moment. If you feel like your feet are too cold or you want a little bit something, then you might drape the blanket over your feet, something like that, or just let it completely cover your legs. So as you get set, if you want to play with that, or you have somebody there with you that can maybe toss the blanket on your legs, ask for some help. All right, so find your way into that posture. If you feel like it's a little too, crunchy underneath your hips, then you may decide that you want to grab a blanket and put it under your hips so you can lay it up against the wall, right? So play with that a moment. And as you get your legs settled at the wall, begin to settle your arms, right? So find a bit of space for the arms to relax off to the edge, maybe out behind you. With the arms relaxed, the shoulders relax, the head melts into the mat. And we bring that attention back to the upper body for just a moment. So as you find your way, begin to wiggle out your toes again. And as you wiggle out the toes, you can, again, roll your ankles left and right, kind of wiggle them side to side. And really, again, no rules to engagement, just letting the legs melt, the feet go soft, you kind of move it about. And completely relax your feet. As you relax the feet, feel as though the feet become heavier. They melt down the legs. The knees are soft. The thigh bones grow a bit heavier. Melt down into the back space, the hips. Take a deep breath in. And a deep breath out. Feel the back of your ribs melting into the mat. Let go of all the tension, all the resistance you might feel in your low back. Take a deep breath in. And as you exhale, imagine your collarbones getting heavier and longer. They melt down the shoulders, down the arm bones. The elbows go soft. The hands are limp and heavy. A deep breath in. And as you exhale, the back of the head melts into the mat. Fall back into your headspace. Take a deep breath in and illuminate the whiteboard in your mind. Illuminate your intention. Take a deep breath out yourself permission here and now to let go of everything else, to honor the journey behind you, to honor stillness and breath, to honor your intention. And take a deep breath in, a deep breath out. Now, as you begin to release from this posture, start by wiggling your toes and your feet again. If your arms need to change position, you can certainly shift them as you start growing your movement. Maybe bending your knees and sliding the feet down the wall a bit. Sometimes a butterfly feels really good here, like we began our practice. Sometimes it's just hugging your knees to your chest. So play with it a little bit as you gain more movement in your legs. And slowly begin to tip right back to the side where you began getting into this posture. You can pause there on the side if you'd like. Just take a moment to find your intention again. And as you feel ready, pushing the floor away, maybe edging away from the wall a bit, and gradually finding your way to seated. And from your seated position, get settled back into your sit bones, lengthening up the spine. On an inhale, reach the arms up to the sky. And as you exhale, capture your intention, bring it back to your heart. Take a deep breath in through the nose. And on your exhale, open the mouth and sigh it out. Letting everything go. On an inhale, touch your hands or your thumbs to your forehead. As if you're honoring and placing that intention right back into that space. Illuminating it. And acknowledging that it's there for you to bring back whenever you need it. We honor the mind. As the hands drop back to the heart, we honor the breath, we honor the body, and honoring light in each of us. Namaste. Thank you for taking a bit of a journey into shoulders and feet and honoring your body and your practice. Enjoy whatever lies ahead of you after this. Thanks for joining me.